Hi everyone, I'm Jayne at Rockin' Worms. I hope you're having a good day. What I'm gonna be doing today is feeding a whole bunch of my worm bins, and I'm going to be feeding them fast food. So I wanna talk to you about what fast food is, how it works in your bin, and why you may or may not want to use it. All right, so let's get into the first bin I'm going to be feeding. This is one of my now grow out bins because it was a nursery bin back in the beginning of March. So it's well over 3 months old. Now the reason it's set up just like this, and this is how it came off of my rack, is I'm prepping this for sifting. So I have part of the bedding here in a thinner layer. So the worms will sense the dryness and start migrating to one end of the bin. Also, I'm feeding this covered end of the bin so they'll also sense the food, and that will again help them migrate down to the one end of the bin and leave this end of the bin much emptier of worms so I can sift easily, okay? But here's the gig. I may not be able to sift this bin out for a couple more days. And what I don't want is any of the worms coming back looking for little bits of food that are still down, you know, in this end of the bin. I want them to stay in the end of the bin that I want them to stay in. So how am I gonna do that? I am going to feed this end of the bin. And what I'm going to show you right now is look at all the worms, right? So there's a lot of worms in here. They're mostly younger because, again, this bin started out just 3 months ago. And I did feed this bin mixed foods, fast and slow foods, on May 30th. And we can see that there's really no sign of food in here. Nope, not really. Okay, so again, I want to feed them and keep them down on my desired end of the bin. And what I'm doing here is just aerating a little bit, but I'm not aerating the whole bin because obviously I want the dry out section of the bin to, you know, not be mixed in to the worms. I want all the worms to stay on this end. So let me do a quick aeration. And you can see just by the way that this end is also getting very close to needing sifting. I just, you know, have to do half a bin at a time because that's what I have time for. So now I'm going to make a little trench for the feeding. Okay, so what am I gonna be feeding them? Fast food. What is fast food? Fast food is basically what it sounds like. It's food that the worms can digest very quickly because it breaks down very quickly in the ecosystem that a mature bin has. That means not only the worms, but the other biota and critters that are in your worm bins will work on this food to break it down. Again, very quickly. Fast food consists of a high percentage of water, and that also helps it, you know, decompose quickly. So what I'm going to do, let me start working on this when I'm talking to you. This is, I'm just taking a handful or two of my pre-compost bedding to function as a base absorption material in the bin, and then I'm going to put a napkin on top of it. I like using my used napkins, one, because it's using used napkins, but two, when I come back in, it helps me just remind myself where the exact feeding zone happened, okay? And also because it's a paper napkin, it will also help absorb the excess moisture, or a lot of this moisture, this lettuce. This is primarily lettuce. I think there might be a couple pieces of cabbage in there, but it's primarily lettuce. It'll help absorb all the water that this food is going to release as it defrosts and breaks down. Okay, so here is a whole bunch of lettuce. Now, because it is fast food, and I do have a fair few worms in here, as you saw briefly in the beginning, I can give them quite a bit of this food. Now, here is some of the pros of using a fast food in your worm bin. One, like I said, it breaks down quickly. I'm gonna put a little bit of the pre-compost on top, just a little bit. And I'm going to add a little bit of worm chow just to make it very attractive, because again, I wanna keep the worms in this end. And I'm going to use a little dolomite lime on top just to offset any, pH changes that might occur because of the vegetable. And also it does add some grit into the bin. Okay, so fast food breaks down quickly. It means that the worms and the other biota will eat it up fast. So one of the benefits of a food being eaten up fast is you get castings faster. It goes through that little worm digestive system at lightning speed. So if you're looking to increase the amount of castings you're getting out of your worm bin, you know, maybe you're ramping up to get ready to do, you know, planting, and you want to be able to put castings into your seedlings, into your, you know, potting when you transplant your new peppers or tomatoes, whatever you're doing. I'm going to put this up because this bin is done. And I'm grabbing another bin, and I didn't want to cover that up, did I? Nope. And we're doing another bin because I have a fair few to work on. Okay, so same thing, it's a little dry. That's great. You can see there's not a lot of worms in here. That's exactly what I want, as I'm gonna be sifting this in the next couple days. There's a couple worms on the plastic, that's perfectly fine. Let me move the almost destroyed paper towel out of the way. Let me show you again. This is a younger bin. It's only a couple months old after the cocoons have hatched. Okay, can you see that? Okay, so you want to get a lot of castings quickly. So feed them fast food if you've got it, because they're going to turn that food into poop as soon as they can. Now, let me put this in. Okay, so another benefit of using fast food, especially when you're getting ready to prep for imminent sifting like I am, is this food will disappear out of the bin within several days. And that means if I do decide to go in and not only sift this dry down end, but maybe I decide to sift down the other end of the bin as well, this food will no longer exist in the bin and it will have been eaten. And so when I go to sift, I won't have chunks of food clogging up my sifters, okay? So it just makes sifting a little bit easier when there's not, you know, larger bits of food or bedding in the way. All right, let me concentrate on this for just a second and get this bin done. And guess what? We're gonna move on to the next bin and I'll continue.
Can you remind us what you just put on there?
Sure. It's a couple handfuls of the pre-compost as an underlayment. It's a used napkin. And you know what? You don't have to use napkins, right? If I had shredded paper, junk mail, sales circulars, I could certainly use some shredded newspaper as a material absorption mechanism, because it breaks down faster than, say, cardboard. Okay, so if you want to, you know, use something other than a napkin, I would suggest using shredded paper and not shredded cardboard. Okay, and then on top of the lettuce, I also put on the dolomite lime to act as a pH buffer and also as grit. And again, always as grit, you can use sand, you can use eggshells, you can use other, you know, rough materials that your worms will eat. I gotta cover this up because they have gizzards and they need to grind their food down before their digestive systems can really handle it for processing. Oh, and I did put in a sprinkle of worm chow as well. Sorry, I forgot that. Oh, you know what? I got a little worm over here. He came off of the newspaper. Look at him. He is not happy being there by himself. So let me just gently pick him up and put him over here back in his bin with his buddies. Cover him up. Let's see. You know what? It looks like they've gone through the newspaper on this one. So let me put on a new newspaper top while I'm in here. Young worms in particular are, you know, really liking newspaper, and they go through it quickly. It's just a favorite food of theirs. And that's also ties back to if you want to use shredded newspaper as your underlayment to absorb the moisture that your defrosting and decomposing fast food lets off, newspaper is a good choice. I have used shredded cardboard in the past as my absorption material, and for me, I didn't care for it because it took too long to break down in the bins that I was getting ready to harvest. And I didn't want that chunky stuff in my bin when I wanted to get ready to sift it. Okay, here's another bin. So let me check my notes here on pros. Easy for the worms to eat, worms like it. Okay, so worms like fast food, right? It's easy. It's tasty for them. And let me put this over here. So fast food also is a good bait for worms when you want to use it to migrate your worms from one end of a bin to another. Now look at this one. I also had open, getting it ready to sift, but it's not as far along as those other two bins were. There's more worms in this end. You know, not tons, but there are more worms. See, there are more worms in here. So this bin just isn't quite as far along in the migration process to empty this end out. So it's even better that I'm coming in now to feed the opposite end so I can help lure these worms down and out of the to be sifted soon end. Again, I'm just doing a quick little aeration here. I don't always remember to aerate it, especially when I'm shooting the videos, folks. I'm trying to remember everything I want to share with you. So if I skip a step, it's just an accident and I can go back and fix it later. But it's all right. So this area has been aerated. Again, you can see all the worms. This bin has, is a more mature bin, if you will. You can see it has much larger slash older worms in it. Okay, and I'm gonna take a couple of those worms from the other end. Again, I'm gonna trench it. All right, so you can use fast food to bait out your worms regardless of why you want to bait them. Maybe you want to bait them because you are going to sift. Maybe you want to bait them because you want to take a bin and split it in half. And it's easier to grab, you know, handfuls of worms and putting in a new bin rather than, you know, move half the contents of a bin. Okay. Maybe you're using fast food in a bait cup in your castings bucket, because it will, again, draw in worms much more quickly than a slower food. Let me give you a couple other examples of fast food, if I didn't mention it already. In addition to lettuces, any kind of melon, watermelon, cantaloupe, muskmelon, any kind of melon, worms really go for. Things like, you know, carrots and apples and things are more slow foods. Okay, so there's the lettuce. Let me put on some of the worm chow. Just a little bit, because I really want them to eat the fast food and not so much the worm chow. Dolomite lime. And I'll just put some more of this on. You know, sometimes I put the pre-compost on top, sometimes I don't. Doesn't matter. They're gonna eat it all. That pre-compost, because it is pre-compost, has tons of active biota in it, which will help, you know, this influx of new biota will help break down the food that I've put in this feeding trench. Okay. Let me put on the newspaper that's falling apart, but there's enough here that for the half bin, because I am drying out the other end, as you know, for sifting. Let me bring this over. Okay. Now I know I have a few worms that, you know, came off of the paper, so let me rescue them and get them back with their buddies. There was only one or two, no big deal. I don't even know if you can see any in here. No, maybe it was just the one. All right, that's fine. All right. So like I said, what is another positive of using fast food? Well, as I mentioned, fast food often has a very high water content in it. So if your bin is a bit on the dry side just overall, and you're not prepping it for sifting, and you need to feed your worms, well, putting in fast food, especially if it's been pre-frozen, will accomplish both tasks. You'll feed your worms and add moisture into your bin at the same time, instead of like spraying it with water, which is, again, perfectly fine. But if you can, you know, kill two birds with one stone, why not do it? Okay, let's see how this end. This end's looking very dry, but not too dry, because you can see there's some worms still in this end. So there's enough in there to make them happy, or at least survivable. But, you know, let's put them over there, because I do want them out. And I'm going to sift this as well. This also is a good reminder for me, looking into a bin like this. This looks really dry to me, right? But obviously there's still worms in here. So the worms can survive and operate and choose to be in conditions that are much drier than I think that they're going to like. But I think I saw a worm. I don't want to squish anybody. Yeah, there he is. Okay. But see, look at, as dry as this looks, it still has moisture in it. So you can run your bins visually drier than you probably think you can, if that makes any sense. And it's a good reminder for me, because sometimes I think I run my bins, I'm just gonna put it down here, I guess, because I don't want to leave those worms in the other work bin. Sometimes I think I run my bin a little wetter than I need to. Look at these guys. Okay. Just, and this is obviously where the food trench was when I fed them on the 30th. I fed everybody on the 30th. You can also see that there's almost no indication. I don't see any indication of that napkin, because everybody got a napkin. Or a piece of newspaper, but most of them got a napkin, so I'm going to stick with that. And I'm just aerating this. But you can see there's no indication of that napkin being there. There's no indication of the last feeding. So we're really ready to feed these guys. And again, keep them down in this end so they don't go wandering back over there looking to forage. Okay, let me trench this. And do it again. Here, look at this guy, okay? So I have red wigglers, as you probably all know by now. So here we go. Look at nice bulgy cotalum, nice yellow tail. This is a big yellow tail. Sometimes it's just the tip. Sometimes it's, you know, looks like it's half their body. And here's another little baby down here. So this is a grow out bin. It has worms of all ages in it. And that's what happens naturally, you know, as your cocoon bins grow up. It goes from a cocoon bin to a nursery bin to a grow out bin. All right, so fast foods, back on topic here. All right, what's the cons of feeding your worms fast food? Well, the biggest con is they eat it really fast. So you have to be prepared to go back in within a couple of days, you know, maybe 5, 6, 7 days, and check and see if they need more food because they've blown through all this fast food. So if you're like, well, I don't have time to go back and check on these worms in 4, 5, 6 days, maybe feeding just fast food doesn't fit with your schedule at this time, and you need to do a mix of fast and slow foods because that's what works best for you. All right. So one of the reasons I'm feeding fast food primarily at this time, in the amounts that I'm doing it, or like in all these bins are getting fast food, is because I got a ton of fast food from my veg place earlier this week, late last week, I don't remember. But it was a whole big box of rotten, nasty, did I put in the Dolan? I did, okay. Nasty lettuces, right? And that is, you know, manna from heaven. As far as I'm concerned, my worms are concerned, it's great food because it's already starting to rot. It already has a lot of bacteria and biota in it, which is only going to be a benefit to my worm bin. So I love getting rotten, nasty food from my veg place. And hey, lettuce is what I got. So guess what? Lettuce is what my worms are being fed. And I'm going to feed it to them until it's gone, because I also need just more room in my freezer. I do pre-freeze my foods because it does help the cell walls burst, break down, and therefore break down easier and faster for the biota and the worms themselves. Let's look at, see how this end is drying out. Looking good. You can see there's a worm here, but not very many. So when I get to, this was a little group there. Maybe I went, dug a little too far. But yeah, this one is definitely getting ready to be sifted out. All right, back to feeding. All right, let's see. Oh, look at this. Oh, I already did this one. Ha, look at that. I pulled out the same bin that I just did. All right, no problem. Let's just put it back. You know what, that happens. I'm not marking these bins because I'm making the video, but I will do that after. Let me just put this back. All right. Other cons are that you're adding a lot of moisture into the bins with this fast food. And so you want to be sure, let's see, let me grab this big one over here. So you want to be sure that you're not putting too much moisture into your bin So watch the moisture levels, okay? You don't want your bedding to get all, you know, soppy wet. So again, looking really good. All this growth is from my worm food. I must not have ground up my bird seed as much as I normally do. See, again, not very many worms in here. That's great. And here is where they all are hanging out, ready for some more food. All right. And this is the last bin I'm gonna feed on camera here. So we're gonna start wrapping this up. But yeah, so you know, managing the moisture in your bin when you have a lot of fast food that is wet food is just something you need to, you know, be aware of. So, you know, add in more carbon, add in more pre-compost, which reminds me, I didn't put pre-compost under here. You know, add more paper. Just, you know, manage your bin. And oh, this is great because this is last of this bowl. I have a whole nother big bowl of lettuce. So these guys are gonna, I'm gonna just pour that in. These guys, I'm actually gonna give them more food. I'm not even gonna cover them up right now on camera. I'm gonna finish feeding them when I, you know, get off here. So the last thing I'm gonna say about the con of fast food is that you do wanna provide your worms with food variety. So even though I am feeding them a lot of lettuce right now, I'm not gonna be feeding them a lot of lettuce for the rest of their lives. The next feeding will be a more of a mixture of fast and slow foods, depending on what I get from my veg guide, but I'll definitely be adding in slow foods, all right? Everybody, worms and humans, benefit from diet variety, okay? But eating fast food once in a while is not a bad thing, okay? You can have a McDonald's for dinner one night or a couple nights a week because you're having a really busy week, but it's not a diet you want to have for the rest of your life. So that's the point, okay? So I hope this video helped you understand some of the pros and cons of feeding fast food into your worm bins, where it can help you out, and where you just need to be aware and pay attention to, okay? So that's it. I hope you found this informative. If you have different ways you use fast food in your bins, please share in the comments below. Again, that's how we learn from each other. And I hope you have a good wormy rest of the day. I am yours in the dirt, Jayne.